Introducing the biggest, sexiest, over-the-top, wow your friends coral grow-out machine, the Waterbox Aquariums Frag System. If you need or just really want a frag system and a 20-gallon DIY option just isn't going to work for you, then check out these beauties. The Waterbox Aquariums Frag Systems are absolutely the top-of-the-line commercially available frag tanks on the market today, period. If you're looking for a less expensive and a smaller frag tank, then check out the innovative marine, shallow reef, and lagoon series. But if you need something big, if you prize clean lines and attention to detail, if you want the benefits that come with a sump and a system you would be proud to display in your living room, then these frag tanks are absolutely worth a look. With four size options available, ranging from a display tank size of 54 gallons all the way to 118 gallons, they actually feel quite a bit larger than their already generous size. That's because the display tank is only 16 inches tall, 2 to 7 inches shorter than a standard aquarium with the same water volume. A shorter height with similar water volume means that the tank has a larger footprint. A 16-inch depth is the perfect size for a frag tank. It's deep enough that you can mount even your large corals inside, but shallow enough so you don't have to get your whole arm into the tank every time you need to move a coral around. Just for a frame of reference as we move along, this model right here is the Frag 105.4, the second smallest of the four available models. All Waterbox frag tanks use ultra clear, low iron, starfire glass that allows 91% of light through. That's 10% more light than standard glass. With beveled edges and precision silicone beads, these rimless tanks are 100% smooth glass. Why is that significant? Because a lot of other tank manufacturers use a textured acrylic overflow box. And if you're like me and love to have a clean black panel instead of it being covered with coralline algae, the glass weir from Waterbox is absolutely perfect because all you need is a stainless steel scraper to keep it crystal clean. Each tank is leak tested before it is shipped to you, and the attention to detail even goes as far as the weir cover. The thick glass cover not only hides the plumbing, it also silences the vast majority of the noise. And finally, the frag system comes with a pre-glued self-leveling foam mat that will minimize the effects of any uneven surfaces and pressure points. I won't stand for a shoddy cabinet. Will it stand up to the test of time? The new standard in aquarium cabinetry. Those are the three best cabinet puns I could come up with, so if you can think of another one, put a comment down below. I'm curious. The Waterbox cabinets are heavy. That is because they are solid plywood with an either white or black UV matte paint finish. You have to assemble it, and I'm not gonna lie to you, these are some complicated yet high quality cabinets with confusing IKEA-like instructions. If you don't have the patience for detailed assembly work, this may be the perfect opportunity to phone a friend for help and just take them out to a nice dinner afterwards to say thanks. I've done a few of these stands, so I'm no novice, but I estimate this took me 2 to 2.5 hours to complete. I was just able to put the cabinet together myself, but I highly recommend getting a helper. These cabinets come with a ton of adjustable feet, so there's no need for composite shims. All four sizes of cabinets are almost 3 feet tall and have several openings in the back, perfect for wire management and dehumidification. Rounding out the modern aesthetic are the cabinet doors. With recessed soft close hinges and magnetic push-to-open doors, when closed, they blend seamlessly into the tank. Waterbox, you glorious aquatic dream makers. The simple fact that the frag system plumbing comes with a gate valve and a manifold proves to me that you've heard, understood, and implemented reefer feedback. Let's go top to bottom, left to right to get a full filtration picture. Starting with the overflow box, you've got your standard Herbie style silent overflow with both 1-inch primary and emergency drain lines and a single 3/4-inch return line that tees out, providing 2 lock line return nozzles with either the standard flared or the variable flow nozzle. Bulkhead installation was an absolute breeze. I didn't need to use any tools, just hand tightened, and it's leak free. Both the primary and emergency drain lines fit neatly into the first compartment, and the included gate valve is so much better than a ball valve because Herbie's style overflows can be tricky to tune, and a gate valve provides a much more precise adjustment. With two included filter socks, the mesh sock will capture all of the large detritus, while the fleece sock will capture all of those finer particles, really polishing your water. Next up is the large compartment designed for protein skimmers, reactors, ceramic media, and even a macroalgae refugium when you use the removable baffle included in the 145.5 and 165.6 frag systems. But by far, my favorite thing about this compartment is the included manifold. I use a reactor from time to time in all of my systems, and I hate having to find space in an already cramped sump for the pump and the extra wire. So Waterbox Aquariums obviously is able to read my thoughts and included a manifold in all of their frag systems. The two smaller frag systems have a single manifold, while the two larger frag systems have a dual manifold. You can use the included barb fitting or hard plumb something yourself. The manifolds are powered by your return pump, so just make sure you take that into consideration and possibly purchase something a little bigger than you normally would. What can you use your manifolds for? Well, really, you can do whatever you want with them, but you're probably going to most commonly use them to power your reactors, algae scrubbers, and UV sterilizers. The water then moves over the final baffle through the included sponge and into the final return pump chamber. The Frag 85.3 and the 105.4 include a 4.5 gallon RODI reservoir as a part of the sump, while the 145.5 and the 165.6 have a separate standalone 13.1 gallon reservoir. Have you noticed how I keep calling these things frag tanks? Well, that's because A, that's what they are, and B, that's what Waterbox calls them. But it's only a frag tank if you're gonna use it for frags. These systems would make a kick-butt mangrove tank, a shallow reef tank, or even a super high-end Fowler tank. We kind of went all out for our Waterbox Frag 105.4 system. Click here for all the detailed instructions, including all of the gear we used. And as always, everybody, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.